for, I think it is in our constitution, especially in the NNPC Act, that you know, the Mr. President, who is the Minister of Petroleum, and which of course we also have the Minister of Petroleum, that is of State. Whatever that is going to happen, I don't see anything wrong as the Minister of Petroleum, also as the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. The issue, the problem, the bond of contention here, Mr. Shehu, is that somebody is just toying, playing with Nigerians, you know, money, and have failed to understand that this country belongs to all of us, not to one individual, not to only Mr. President, not to EJ or Speaker or Senate President. All of us collectively, we are part of this nation. And I'm pained to see what has happened to this country's wealth, resources meant to develop this nation. And we are still trying to crawl instead of walking. And we are having blame games, pointing fingers at each other. What is important is for us to understand, look, enough is enough of this rubbish, of this stupidity of corruption, that the fight against corruption, it is something that every patriotic Nigerians should try as much to support Mr. President on this special day. This is why you've seen a lot of bigotry, agitation, because when you fight corruption, guess what? Corruption fight back at you. There's nothing wrong for Mr. President being the minister and also being the president. That is not the problem. The problem is where our money, Nigerians' resources, gone to global destination through dubious means.
All right, we'll get to that. We'll get to that point in a moment. I just want us to take up this issue and perhaps trash it legally speaking, Mr. Ikeji. What does the law say? Can Nigerian president, because the argument from the point of law, from the senior advocate's argument, is that the president, if he's going to take up a ministerial position, or anybody that is going to be in the cabinet as a minister, should go through the Senate screening.
Well, the argument of going through the Senate screening, in my view, it's secondary to the question of whether or not the president can hold executive office. I thank Willis Abakoba, senior advocate of Nigeria, for raising this issue. The challenge that he would have is the challenge of low-cost standard, but we'll get to that issue if time permits. If you look at section 138 of the 1999 Constitution, and by the way, the fact that it has been done before does not make it right. Section 138 of the 1999 Constitution, as amended, provides as follows, and I read, mark the words that I use, I'll be very deliberate. The president shall not, during his tenure of office, hold any other executive office or paid employment in any capacity whatsoever. In any capacity whatsoever, any other executive office. Now, if you look at chapter 6, part 1 of the Constitution, it provides for federal executive. It is under this part that ministers are appointed. And if you look at the makeup, the composition of the Federal Executive Council, you will agree with me that ministers are members of the Federal Executive Council. That means simply that ministers are members of the executive. In other words, a minister is holding an executive position. Having cleared that, the question is the president holding an executive position if he is holding the position of Minister of Petroleum Resources? I think the answer is clear and simple. Yes, he is holding a position of executive where he is holding the position of the Minister of Petroleum. So I think that it is unconstitutional for the president to hold that executive position. It is clearly against the express provision of this section 138. But it doesn't just stop there. you also look at it from the moral perspective. And when you look at it from the moral perspective, you would ask the question, why exactly is he the Minister of Petroleum Resources? Why exactly is he holding on to that ministry? Are we trying to develop the Petroleum Resources Ministry, or do we need to diversify our economy and as a result get the executive president to concentrate on areas that need to be propped up, areas like agriculture, areas like science and technology? I think that, morally speaking, those are the areas where the president can decide if he wants to breach the constitution to put his attention on. But for him to hold the position of Minister of Petroleum Resources, I am in alignment with the thinking of Olusegun Obasanjo that it is unconstitutional. Okay. But it doesn't stop there. It requires the court to so declare it. But for the court to so declare it, Olusegun Obasanjo would have to prove that he suffers more inconvenience over and above the ordinary Nigerian. And that is where...
Whether or not he has a local standing on this matter. Before we go on the break, we dig our feet into this issue of the rot in the oil sector. And give us a premise, Honorable Agboima. You were the one who brought this case before the House of Reps. We have about a few seconds before we go on this break. But tell us, it's over a year now since the House says there's going to be an investigation into $17 billion of undeclared crude oil to global destinations. Tell us, what has happened so far?
Well, I must thank the Speaker and the Attorney General of the Federation for the wonderful support. But let me tell you that, you know, when you're talking about investigation, it's not something you just do overnight. It takes time to get the right result, to get the right information. As you can see, the interview just played, that was some of my interaction with the lawyers in America, that's Jerome Stalin. I spoke to him, and I met with some of those that have been helping Nigeria in the recovery of the looted fund in America and other part of the world. So we are still working to see that we can return the money that belongs to this nation back to Nigeria. I think Nigerians deserve to have this money back in order to develop our dear nation.
All right.
I know it is tough because as you are fighting corruption.
Honorable Agboima, just pause today. There. You know? We need to take a break, and when we come back, we'll dig deeper into why hasn't this money been brought back to Nigeria? This crude oil, why have we not been able to get to the bottom of it? That's after now. Join us again, everyone.